Stop focusing on you again. You're too beautiful. Michael and I are currently having a heated discussion about what time Tesco closes. I am 100% certain it's 4. Michael is 100% certain it's
4:30 or 5. Not 4.
It really does close at 4. So this is the Audi Q5, which is one of their 4x4 versions. So yeah, the actual like space and everything's okay, but I don't feel like it's a bigger car. I'll be interested to see how I feel when we get back into our other car. I think that's when I'd notice it more. So like I was trying to explain, this is my only window, whereas in the TT I've got a much bigger window, so it feels like it's less claustrophobic. It's hard to explain this to someone that doesn't get it. I know there'll be maybe a few of you that do, but so that's kind of my main thing about being in the car, is I don't like feeling like closed in and trapped in it. Like, I don't feel it's any bigger, even though it's much bigger. But yeah, it's space, actually not.
Space has everywhere else.
Yeah, so yeah, like, because we now obviously have back seats, whereas in the TT you've just got like a bench seat, there's a bigger boot, and all that kind of stuff. But yeah, around here, which is obviously where I sit, I don't feel that there is actually any more space, which Michael's slightly relieved about, because he loves his car. And I think you would have been a bit gutted if I'd been like, this is the best car, we have to get it.
No, because if you felt that way about it, then it would be a no-brainer, because it's not like I dislike this car.
Yeah.
It's just, I love my TT, and if I can keep my TT forever, then I'll keep my TT forever.
Yeah.
Well, the RS when I get it.
Okay. So yeah, I'll probably next see you in Starbucks. I'm back to just vlogging you eat.
You do like doing that, don't you?
How's your muffin?
I wish it didn't have lemon jelly in it.
That looks nice.
It's going to be a bit too much lemon for me.
Is it lemon curd? This isn't focusing on it. Wait. That looks nice. Enjoy. Oh my god, Michael. We've made it to our next destination, which is Tesco. Yay! I hate it, and it's nearly closing because it's nearly 4 o'clock.
We'll see.
We will see, Michael. We will.
It's the 4 p.m.
It closes at what time?
4 p.m.
We are home from our adventure. It was not even slightly adventurous. I did get a book though. I asked on Instagram the other day for some book recommendations, and I've downloaded a few, but the tablets that I'm on make my eyes funny. So I'm finding it quite hard to read on a screen, which I think it's them. I have an eye appointment soon, but I got this. Sunday Times bestseller. It's like just a crime thriller type thing. One of my New Year's resolutions was to read more. So January's book was The Warden by Mr. Trollope, which I enjoyed. My mum got me that for Christmas. And so February's book, I think I'll do this one, and I'm gonna squeeze in another because I'm gonna have the time. Look at all this mess. Michael has taken the car back to Audi. I don't know, I really thought that it was going to be kind of like groundbreakingly wonderful to be in a big car again, but it wasn't. I think I prefer what we have. So when he gets back, we're gonna go out in our car to see if I did prefer the other one. That's it. I'm trying to convince Michael to download Resident Evil 7 because we played the trailer for it. Oh my gosh, it was so good, but very scary. Michael is currently making roast. We've got some potatoes, paprika, and a turkey in here. We've just got a text from some friends who are down the road at the pub, so we're gonna go up there for a little bit whilst this cooks and see them. I feel like you've not been in it much today.
It's because you don't like me. You don't want me to be in it. You want to be the star. You don't want me to have any spotlight. I don't know why I always whisper.
I don't know why you whisper.
I don't know. It's probably a little bit creepy.
Happy Monday morning. although it's nearer to afternoon now. Some posters just arrived from the, are we gonna focus? Croydon Candle Co. Hello. I gave him this, what's it called? Roll, and he's just been carrying it everywhere this morning. He loves it. I have some candles, 4 candles. It's this big one. Oh, clean cotton, I like the sound of that. And then these are cute. You can obviously personalize them for your wedding. This one's honeysuckle and jasmine. This one's wild lemongrass, I like the sound of that. And this one comes in a cute cotton bag. This one is coconut palm. Oh, I don't know if I like the sound of that one. That's very nice. I will have a burn of those today. So, how to get? Shush, I am off work this week. I'm just taking some time off. I'm trying not to check email or anything like that. I've got my girls, Emily and Rebecca, on it. If anything is major, then they will let me know. So I'm good. Atticus. I'm doing house chores at the moment, and then I'm going to find a film to watch. I love working in the wedding industry because I get sent such pretty things. And this is some paper pretty from De Winton Paper Co. Just look at this. I'm about to write a thank you note, so I thought I'd use one of these. And then on the other ones. Isn't that gorgeous? All hand illustrated. And then I can't do this because I've only got one hand, or can I? I got one of these. Oh, so old school. And they're all illustrated on the inside. I think this would be such a fun idea to have on the tables at weddings, and then you could do little pictures of something to do with you, and then have little facts behind them about the couple. Love this, it's so pretty as well. Oh, yeah. I was a winter bride because I like being cold. I've just opened the other little packet too. Look how gorgeous this is. I know the camera's not gonna pick up, but the paper and the illustration is just gorgeous. And this, my hair's no. It's very 2017 Pantone greenery. So pretty. And I found this one actually, which it's got little coppery gold specks, which I'm gonna use for the thank you note. A little bit late in the day, it's the afternoon. I've had a nice chill day. I haven't really done much of anything really, just sort of pondered around the house, did a few chores, and I'm now just running a bath, and then I'm going to be editing the next vlog, which may or may not include this. It depends how much footage, because it was of the week when I started feeling really poorly, so I'm not sure how much there is. I've had a really nice day today. It's been quite nice not really to do anything, and the dog's just over there. I realise that in this camera that radiator looks pink. Maybe it is slightly pink in real life. How good am I though? My birthday present is right there. I've not touched it. Good afternoon. I am about to go to the post office. I'm feeling better again today, so I have errands to run and a few like little bits to do that I've kind of been putting off for the last little while, so I can finally get around to doing all those little bits. The only thing today is that I've got the wrong contact lenses in. I've run out of my current ones, so I've had to put old ones in, which are the wrong prescription, and I am very short-sighted. So this one's -5.5 and this one's -6, and the ones that I've got in are -4. So, and they're both -4. I didn't have like a different one to put in the other one to get some depth perception. So at the moment, my vision is very blurry. So I'm kind of just, it's in a straight line. I'm just gonna go walk and I'll get to the post office. I'll make it there. Just, I will not really, yeah, nothing will be in detail on the way there. BB, camera, when I get talking, I sort of forget and then I sort of drop it. And Michael says all the time, whenever I edit back through footage, I'm like, and he's like, you dropped it. I'm sorry, I'm still adjusting. This one, much better than that green one. So Michael's gaming, he's getting very annoyed.
I am.
I've just been switching up the cushions in here for something a bit springier. And I'm about to go for a bath and leave this guy next to the fire. Hello, you shouldn't be up on there, should you? I'm not sure what our plan is yet. But we're watching the rugby with Michael's dad tonight and going to his mum's for dinner this evening. I'm trying to watch Big Brother on catch-up, but for whatever reason, whoever edited it and put it up onto their 5OD did a really crap job. I'm just at the bath and I'm going to do my makeup. I always get my contact lenses from Feel Good Contact Lenses. This is not sponsored. And I love it because they always put in some sweets and I'm just like, that is exactly what I want. The joy of sight and to be able to see the sweets that I'm eating. My hair cutting. It's getting a bit too long, I think. I love this jumper from The White Company, but look how filthy my mirror is. Because it has, I don't know if you can see, a silk back to it, it fits weirdly under the arm, like it kind of ruches under there. I'm now just gonna wait for Michael and then I'm not sure what we're gonna do. Because it's a lot later than planned. But I'm feeling much better today, which is a great thing because I was getting quite bored of feeling unwell. My hair really does need doing. It was booked in, it was meant to be done on Thursday. However, it's my birthday on the 23rd. And I realized that by the time it got round to the 23rd, I'd have roots and I'd need my hair doing it again. So I've canceled it and I'm getting it done closer to my birthday. Which means that I've got to deal with roots up until then, which is lame. Do you know what I mean? It could just be because I've got fat arms. I don't know. I think I've done my brows too dark today. A little bit of scalp brow on. So the plan for tomorrow is maybe to go and get my ears pierced, depending on how I feel, because my tummy's still a bit iffy. So I want to get these done again, and then maybe something here, and maybe something there. I haven't properly decided yet, but you can just walk into the pierces that's in town. So if I feel up to it, then I may go and get that done. I'm not sure. And also, I'm thinking about getting some tattoos. Sorry, Mum. But when I go to get my ears pierced, I'll ask them all about it. This is my 30 life crisis, because I will be 30 in 19 days now. So that's fun for tomorrow, and then we may go for drinks. We may go to the cinema. With my CBT, I meant to do, it's called graded exposure. So you may see that we are still kind of, we're still going to the same places because that's how exposure works. So you don't just then start going everywhere. You keep repeating until you're comfortable and then you go, oh, let's add something on. So now that I'm almost comfortable, what's with my eyes? Now that I'm almost comfortable with the cinema, we then add something on. So it could be drinks before, it could be dinner before, it could be something afterwards. And that's how sort of graded exposure works. You just keep on adding stuff and then you realize that, oh, I was in town today for a total of 6 hours. And then you think, well, I could do something else for that amount of time, if that makes sense. Because I've been to the cinema, I think three times. I'm going to add something onto it. And I think we'll do drinks because there's so many places that I want to go in town that do amazing gin, but it's all dependent on how my stomach's doing. At the moment it's okay, so it's looking good.
Don't go to the light, Caroline.
Waiting on Michael to finish in the shower and then we're just going to pop to Tesco because the stuff that we need can be bought there because we're just buying for lunch today. And I need to go to the bottle bank and buy stuff like tinfoil and there's no point going all the way up to M&S for that. God, that boy takes ages in the shower. Genuinely ages. He says he's quick, but he's not. Oh, that's bright. We're in Tesco. We've just bottle banked.
Oh my God, I'm excited.
finding somewhere to park.
The moment I wake up,
how many dangers? So yeah, we're just gonna grab some shitty lunch. Michael is very excited for...
I'm gonna make cheese toasties.
Yeah, because someone mentioned that at work.
That's not that exciting, but I haven't had one. I don't even know when the last time I had one.
No.
I wish they didn't have the chocolate crullers. And this isn't a true honey cruller. It should be lighter in between, in the middle, but...
People I'm so don't. Jealous.
Peanut butter.
A billionaire, that sounds amazing. Chocolate dream cake, that's what you are.
Thanks, baby.
You're welcome.
I can't like a tiramisu, to be honest, but... I think I'll just...
Reese's peanut butter?
Peanut butter one's a bit boring, but they don't have the PB&J.
Nutty chocolata?
In honour of Steady, I will.
I don't really see how you can get toastie making wrong.
No, it needs to be perfect. It's not about getting it wrong or right. It's about it being one of the best things you've ever eaten in your entire life.
He's frying it. Who makes a toastie like this?
People who know how to make toasties make a toastie like this.
So you've buttered one side and now it's frying.
Yeah, so I'm gonna fry it, brown the other side of the bread.
Mm-hmm.
When it's brown,
yeah.
I'm gonna take both pieces out of the pan.
Yeah.
Butter the other side.
Yeah.
Put the cheese on the already toasted bit, which I'll already start putting heat through it.
Yeah.
And then toast both sides of the sandwich.
Okay.
That makes sense?
That sounds disgusting.
Shake brings all the boys to the yard and they're like, it's better than yours, damn right, it's better than yours, I could teach.
Are you excited?
I am.
Are you gonna put anything else with it?
No.
No. I like cheese and onion toasties.
Vile.
Maybe some ketchup to dip it in.
No.
No, just how it is.
Techniques that freaks this boy.
Can you hear that crunch, baby? That's what you want. That's the level of crunch you want. Got my two cheeses in there. It's not focusing very well. Have a while, it's still red hot. Mmm. Oh my god.
So we've just finished watching the rugby. Won. We won. Just. We didn't deserve to win. We played really bad. And now I'm getting ready because we're going for dinner. So I'm quickly taking him for a very quick walk, and then we're going up to my mother-in-law's. I'm going to take the camera. This is great vlogging, isn't it? Hey, I'm going to take the camera with me, but I don't know if I'll film. However, she has got lots of dogs, so. I may get that in. Just left mother-in-law's. It's 10 to 11 and the car is all frosted, so he's out there defrosting.